human dermis or from the animal dermis, all the cells are destroyed. They are dead, they have been removed, and it is a decellularized dermis. And this dermis is then put over the wound bed as a cover, and from the underlying tissue, the new cells, the skin cell and the melanocytes and the keratinocytes grow into this dermis as a scaffold, and a new skin develops. So this is basically a theory on which these materials are being based. So the most common is an alloderm. Alloderm, as you say, is an acellular dermis. That is, it is a dermis but having no cells. It is taken from skin of cadavers. It is cell-free, and this is being used in breast surgery, tendon repairs, and in wound coverage. So this is basically a replacement for the dermis. And in this dermis, the various keratinocyte cells they grow, which can be covered with a skin graft. And this is how a skin substitute is made. This is one of the most commonly used skin substitutes. Another skin substitute is an applegraft. This is a living cell. Now here, this is apart from alloderm, this is a living cell substitute in which cells are present. It is a bilayered skin substitute, and this is derived from bovine collagen and human fibroblast. So here we have a combination of human fibroblast and bovine collagen, and they promote skin. So these we get in the form of sheets, and they are very good in chronic venous ulcer and diabetic foot ulcer. The only problem is that the cost is very, very high. Third is bioprene, again a very newly coming common skin substitute, and this is used in burn conditions. So basically it is a synthetic nylon mesh which is bonded to silicone, and it is coated with collagen, and it acts like a dermis, and it has pores which allow the exudate to be drained. So it is like a dressing over the burned wound, and it allows the dermis to regenerate, and then the epidermis comes over it. Then comes Integra. So Integra is one of the most expensive and a very good dressing for full thickness burns. So it is a porous matrix of coarse link, bovine, tendon, collagen and glycoserm. So it acts like a scaffold for the cellular invasion. So again, it is a dermal substitute in which the capillaries in the cells grow and they cover them. So coming back, we'll just summarize is that we have a lot of dressings coming up. There are a lot of dressings coming up. The common dressing today are the hydrogel, hydrocolloid and the foam dressing. The hydrocolloid dressings, they provide wound. The hydrogels provide a barrier, and the foam dressings, they act as an absorbent layer. So depending upon what is the exudate of the wound, we have to choose the type of dressing. And the future is in the various type of skin substitute we are coming up. And these skin substitute can be single layer skin substitute and multi-layer skin substitute. The problem with these skin substitute are they have good results, but they are very expensive and are very difficult to procure. Thank you. Skin bank again you have to remember is that skin bank जैसा हम सोचते वैसा है होता नहीं है. Skin bank is again a dressing only, क्योंकि इसमें हम दूसरे person का skin लेते हैं, उसको preserve करते हैं, और फिर जिसकी भी burn wound है, जिसका भी deep wound है, जिसका अपना skin नहीं आ रहा है, उसके ऊपर ये skin लगा देते हैं. पर जैसे आप जानते हैं किसी दूसरे का स्किन एक आदमी पे नहीं लग सकता, तो ये भी कभी लगता नहीं है, पर ये एक टेम्पररी कवर की तरह से काम करता है. सो इट एक्ट्स लाइक अ ड्रेसिंग. अगेन फॉर द स्किन बैरियर टू एक्टिवेट, द फर्स्ट थिंग इज दैट देयर शुड नॉट बी ग्रॉस इन्फेक्शन. अगर ग्रॉस इन्फेक्शन है, लेट हमने लगाया है, तो वो भी ड्रेसिंग चली जाएगी. तो द स्किन बैंक इज एक्चुअली अ ड्रेसिंग मटीरियल, इज अ बैरियर, एंड ये 2 से 3 हफ्ते तक वहां रहता है, फिर स्किन हट जाता है. उतने टाइम में नई स्किन अपने आप से जनरेट हो जाती है. दैट इज व्हाट इज स्किन बैंक. व्हाट इन इंडिया मैक्सिमम स्किन बैंक्स आर यूजिंग ग्लिसरॉल. is 95% glycerol जिसमें skin preserve करते हैं, ये skin जो है almost 3 to 4 years तक preserve हो जाता है, there is no problem. अगर इसको आप minus 8 degrees पर 8 degrees पर और freezer में रखते हैं तो ये 3 to 4 years तक आराम से preserve करते हैं, so that is a very good time. और ये काफी सस्ता है, this is no glycerol, 95% glycerol, 80% glycerol बहुत महंगा नहीं है, so it is very easy to preserve and manage a skin. The problem is with the donation. लंबे टाइम हो जाते हैं तब जनरली प्लास्टिक सर्जन की जरूरत होती है इसमें, और किस तरह से इनको कैसे अप्रोच किया जाए, तो कहने का मतलब ये कि ऐसी कोई भी ड्रेसिंग जो आपके पास आए बताएं, तो ऐसी कोई ड्रेसिंग नहीं होती है जो वुंड हील करती है, वुंड हीलिंग अपने आप से होती है, सिर्फ ड्रेसिंग उस कंडीशन को मेंटेन करने के लिए होती है. तो ये थोड़ी सी स्किन की एनाटॉमी है, देयर इज एन एपिडर्मिस जो ऊपर की एपिडर्मिस है, देन देयर इज डर्मिस एंड देयर इज अ सबक्यूटेनियस टिश्यू. तो इस डर्मिस में ये हेयर फॉलिकल्स स्वेट ग्लैंड है जिसमें भी एपिडर्मल एलिमेंट्स होते हैं जहां स्किन ग्रो करता है. So, wound healing stages, these are the stages. There is an inflammatory phase, which is last for about 7 to 10 days. Then there is a proliferative phase, which is 2 to 3 weeks. And then there is a remodeling phase, which continues. So, these are the three basic phases of wound healing. So, these are the type of wounds. So, the types of wounds which we encounter or the plastic surgeon is called upon are the pressure ulcers, venous stasis ulcer and diabetic wound. These are the most three common ulcers or the wounds which are managed by plastic surgeon. So what is a chronic wound? Any wound which is arrested in its one of its phase. So the three phases hote hain wound healing ke. Agar koi bhi wound us wound phase mein arrest ho jata hai, aage nahi badhta hai, heal nahi karta hai, to chronic wound ho jata hai. So any wound which is more than 3 weeks to 3 months old generally is known as a chronic wound. An ulcer is again a chronic wound in which the cause of that the wound is basically internal. Because of some pathophysiology within the body, this wound has developed. And then is a very important concept of biofilm. This is one concept which all the practitioners and everybody should understand. That a lot of bacteria actually they secrete some sort of a polysaccharide matrix around them. So these type of wounds, although they look good granulating wounds, they have a biofilm around them. So if all the antibiotics and all the medications which we give to the patient generally don't help in healing the wound, because these biofilms prevent the local antibiotics to act upon them, and therefore a good debridement is required before these wounds can heal. Then there are other lesions in which the plastic surgeons are called upon, like necrotizing fasciitis, again which is a very severe form of ulcers and wounds, and they are basically treated like major skin trauma, and early closure of the wound is required. Then toxic epidermal necrosis, again because of drug allergies, again they have to be managed by as an acute burn. So now comes the problem. Once we are faced with a wound, this is the problem, that you have a lot of people coming up with a lot of dressing material. You have a lot of medical companies coming that this dressing material is better, this dressing material is better, this heals the wound, this works. So the second thing is, the most important concept for us plastic surgeons is this. It is not these dressing materials. It is this, optimal moisture in the wound. This is against the normal concept of, with the layman concept of, ki wound sukhana hai, bhav sukhana hai. So actually a dry wound is not a good wound. For healing to occur, there should be optimal moisture, because this optimal moisture leads to the cell being alive, the skin being alive, and ultimately healing occurs. So what is an ideal dressing? An ideal dressing should be non-adherent to the wound bed, should conform to the wound bed shape and obliterate all the dead space. Apart from it, it should decrease the bacterial load, prevent debridement, promote granulation tissue and be able to absorb the exudate. So this is an ideal dressing. Now any dressing which has all these qualities will be a good dressing. So now we'll see how to judge a dressing material and how to apply them. And last but not the least is the most important part for us is that any dressing material should be economically viable. The patient should be able to afford that dressing material. So the most common dressing material which we use is the gauze. Again, commonest and the cheapest, but the problem with these gauze dressings are that they require very frequent change and they stick to the wound bed. And once they are changed, it causes a lot of pain to the patient and also it gives a non-selective debridement. To prevent that, we basically use paraffin gauze dressings along with normal gauze to prevent wound adherence. Then are the new dressing materials which you will hear a lot from a lot of medical company representatives, like calcium alginate dressings or fiber gelling dressing. Basically these alginates are absorbents. So what they do is they absorb all the fluid and all the exudates which is coming from the wounds in high quantity, and by absorbing these wounds, which is about 20 times their weight, they prevent these exudates from spilling out and help in providing optimal moisture and a good wound healing. These which actually cover the wound after damage to the skin, especially when the damage is more than the epidermis. So what we have to remember is that simple epidermal damage, the body can always heal it spontaneously. But once the damage is beyond epidermis, into the dermis, then spontaneous wound healing can be a problem. And this is where these skin substitutes can occur. So the number one thing which we hear is stem cells. And there are a lot of products coming having stem cells. So stem cells still as a wound healing, as a skin substitute, is far from normal. It is still in its, what we call is in the experimental stage. This is because what we have seen is through various experiments and is that the cultured skin tissue substitutes, they are fraught with extremely high cost. Secondly, the skin which we get from these stem cell regenerates are subnormal, and the skin graft which we develop from these is again not very good. So apart from it, the synthetic materials which we use are the polyesters, the nylons, the polygalactin meshes and the silactin meshes. It is these meshes in which the normal skin scaffold tends to grow. Then we have natural sources like collagen, elastin, fibrin. All these things are there. They are basically decellularized matrices. What
exactly is transplant? And I'll just take you through common.
सर सब कुछ सामने लिखेंगे।